Greetings and salutations, artists, and welcome to Everything You Need to Know About Character Design, Episode 4, where we'll be doing away with our birthday suits and talking about clothes and accessories. So we've learned throughout the series that a good character design needs to not only be visually appealing, but also convey to the audience their purpose and personality. Basically, show, don't tell. Clothes play a huge part in this because they'll usually be the things controlling the color scheme, shape language, and silhouette. We talked about color associations in our previous video, so if you haven't seen it, then how dare you come here first? I'm kidding! Or am I? In that video, I mentioned to keep in mind the 60-30-10 ratio, make sure your values are not too similar when they're supposed to be different, and to remember the feeling that certain colors give off. Shapes are also present in clothes, if you can believe it. If you remember our shape language video, you'll remember our shape associations too, like square characters being stubborn or circles being cute. A bulky sweater or poncho might have a square look to it, and a three-piece suit might feel triangular. The patterns or designs on clothes can also add to shape language or personality, even if they don't affect silhouette. This is called symbolism, and it means using images or symbols to represent something. A good recent example of this is the clothes of the characters in Disney's Encanto. The main characters are the Madrigal family, who have unique magical gifts like shape-shifting, future-telling, or being crazy strong. I'm going to directly disobey the song We Don't Talk About Bruno and talk about Bruno, because he's my favorite character. His gift is telling the future, and the symbol he is associated with throughout the movie is the hourglass. It's on his door, in his room, and on his poncho. It's a subtle detail, but a really powerful tool for conveying his character. The state of a character's clothes can also indicate status. You know, you've got California on your shirt, Texas on your pants, haha, I'm so funny. No, I mean, like, are they baggy hand-me-downs or brand new and form-fitting? A character with old baggy clothes probably doesn't have a lot of money or resources to buy fancy schmancy gear. Characters can also just wear clothes that they like, but this is also telling of their personality. You've got an entire spectrum of styles to choose from goth to Harajuku fashion, and they all tell you something about the person. I could literally go on indefinitely about all the ways clothes can change a character, but I think in order to keep it simple, I'll just give an example. Here's a quick drawing of one of my characters, a woman named Brunhilde. Over the course of her story, she goes from working for an evil corporation to becoming a freedom fighter against it. While working there, she wears a form-fitting, red, monochromatic outfit. The tightness of the outfit is a metaphor for her being constrained by her evil robot boss. Red is an angry color, and the monochromaticness of the outfit lacks individuality. When she realizes that the company is evil and wants to destroy it, she trades in her suit for baggy, cool-colored clothes and joins the other freedom fighters. Her jackets are also complementary colors, red and green, so that is also a sneaky way to show how much she changes over the course of the story. Obviously, she's not knowingly sifting through a pile of clothes to find that perfect green that's opposite of her red suit jacket. It's just a tool used by artists to convey meaning. And now we're just going to touch on the concept of accessories. Accessories can range from bags to jewelry to magic staffs to wands, basically anything that the character carries that isn't clothes. They can show status, or what the character finds aesthetically pleasing, or something that has deep personal meaning. Or they can indicate occupation, like a wizard. I hope that my lecture was extremely informative and didn't make your brain feel too much like soup. Same as our previous videos, practice makes better art, because there is no such thing as perfect. Just experiment until you create a design that you love that tells an awesome story. Thanks for coming by today. We'll see you next time, and remember to get inspired. Bye!